Hello and welcome to Business Standard's afternoon news update. Here are the top stories. Manmohan Singh hints towards more FDI reforms on the anvil. Bajaj Auto reports first quarter profit in line with estimate at 738 crore rupees. And Sudarshan Venu is officially inducted in the TVS Motor Board. Now the news in detail. Conceding that the high current account deficit and rupee depreciation have aggravated the macroeconomic situation, Prime Minister Manmohan Singh said that more foreign direct reforms are on the anvil, while listing out the various positive measures undertaken by the UPA government to improve India's finances and bolster growth. Singh also attempted to silence the government's critics by saying that they are just focusing on one bad year and the average GDP growth in the last 8 years of the UPA has been 8.2% per annum. However, he said that the positive impact of the measures taken to correct the petroleum prices have been slightly dented due to the depreciation of the rupee against the dollar. Bajaj Auto reported a flat first quarter profit that matched expectations as its exports benefited from a weaker rupee, offsetting sluggish sales volumes. It posted a net profit of 738 crore rupees for the quarter that ended in June. The company said in a statement that taking into account the current trend of the rupee vis-a-vis the US dollar and the current position of hedged contracts, a further benefit on account of the depreciating rupee would accrue to the company in the coming quarters. In terms of market share, the company declared that it was majorly successful in improving its share in the diesel passenger car segment to about 32%. The company's launch of various upgrades in this sector and the release of new permits contributed to this rise. TVS Motor today got the nod from its shareholders to induct 24-year-old Sudarshan Venu, son of TVS Motor Chairman and Managing Director Venu Srinivasan, into the company's board. The company's shareholders approved his appointment as an additional director of the company at TVS Motor's 21st AGM held at Chennai today. He was earlier appointed as Vice President of the company with effect from December 2011. Upon his appointment today as a director, he has also become a whole-time director of the company for a period of 5 years, commencing February 2013. That's all we have for now. Keep watching this space for more news.